أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطيع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد قال الله تعالى في الكتاب المجيد فرقان الحميد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم أفلا يتدبرون القرآن صدق الله العظيم بدر سيسر الإسلام السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته I'm going to paraphrase the Arabic portion of khutbah Indeed all praises to God Almighty we praise Him we ask for His help we seek refuge in Him From our inner soul, from our bad deeds, whomsoever God Almighty guide, no one can astray. Whomsoever He does not guide, no one can guide. I bear witness, no one is worthy of worship except God Almighty alone. Muhammad's messenger, servant, peace and blessing upon him and his followers. O believers, have a conscious awareness of God. Die not except total submission to God Almighty alone. O mankind, have a conscious awareness of God. He has created you from a single soul. From that soul, He made many pairs. Especially be dutiful to those whom you have mutual rights. Indeed, God is all-watching. O believers, be mindful of God. Speak nothing but truth so He can rectify your deed. He can forgive your sins. Best among you, follow God Almighty and Sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For today's khutbah, I have chosen ayah from Surah An-Nisa of Allah Yatadabbaroon al-Quran. When you're going to ponder about the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, about the Quran, when you're going to think about it, when you're going to reflect upon it, when you're going to pay attention to it. In the context of that ayah, inshallah, today I'll focus on Surah Al-Jumu'ah, Surah number 62. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to recite Surah Al-Jumu'ah and Surah Al-Munafiqoon, Surah number 62 and 63 in Salat Al-Jumu'ah. And some narrations say he used to recite Surah Al-A'la and Surah Al-Ghashiya in Salat Al-Jumu'ah. Because you have to think about at that time, the Sahaba, the companion, majority of them behind, used to understand what he's reciting, what the message is. Because the same language, and the tazkiyah, the feeling, love of Qur'an. So when he's reciting, imagine Imam being Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and you're behind and you understand what he's saying. So Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to choose these two surahs, or four surahs, depending, you know, some Jummah with the Jummah and Munafiqun, and other Jummah with Surah Al-Ala and Surah Al-Ghashiyah. I generally recite Surah Al-Asr and Surah Al-Ikhlas, because they're small, short, people have to go back to work. And also, as Imam Shafi rahimullah said, the Quran is the best revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for mankind guidance. But just Surah Al-Asr is more than enough for me and for mankind if you pay attention to it. And as for Surah Al-Ikhlas, this is the essence of Allah's unity and Tawheed. Because Islam is the only religion that from the beginning till now until end focus on the unity of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Jewish tradition has gone off track and Isaiah tradition have gone off track. But as for the Muslims, the unity of God is the core foundation of Islam. La ilaha illallah, Adam Safiullah, to La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it's been the same. So therefore I generally choose those two. But today inshallah we'll talk about Surah Al-Jummah, and we need to reflect upon the context of ayah when we're going to ponder about the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam is reciting Surah Al-Jummah? Why? What's the reason? And he's doing it in congregation prayer, where the majority is getting together after 7 days. Obviously, if you read the Sahaba's introduction, it starts out by saying, so-and-so and bin so-and-so and son of so-and-so never missed Salat for 40 years with Jama'at. 30 years, 10 years, Allahu Akbar. And I wonder, you know, if, again, it's a reminder for myself and all of us, did we pay 10 Salat in past 40 years on time? Think of that, you know, their taqwa, their reflection, their closeness to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, their understanding of message. So these are the Sahaba behind Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam reciting the surah in full congregation, everybody understand what's going on. Why did he choose the surah? So there is a reflection for us. Surah Al-Jumu'ah is surah number 62, it's only 11 ayat, very simple, small. I'll strongly suggest that you go home today, inshallah, and read it with the translation, try to understand it. Why? As a student of Islam, in my reflection is that, you know, the lesson that I can take from that surah, why Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is reciting again, as Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's tradition reflect, the Quran, la tunkizi, there is nothing, you never get bored from this book, so much, it's like ocean. So for a basic general hadaya, you can just grab a water and take it and you'll survive. But if you want to deep dive into it, to seek more knowledge and become a scholar of it, it's ocean. Keep on going down, deeper and deeper, the starfish, the shark, you know, a lot of things, they'll never ever finish. So therefore, when it comes to basic hadaya, it's very easy. When it comes to knowledge of fiqh, the ilm and focus, it is very, very, very rich book. So we have to pay attention and think about why. So inshallah, whatever lesson I can attain from this, and I can relate, I will inshallah share with you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us guidance to act upon them. May Allah give us the wisdom and vision to understand the Quran and love Quran and, you know, implement in our life and convey to others the hikmah. This surah has quite an 11 ayah, but let's just pick a couple of them, inshallah, we'll go through them quickly. One ayah is, هو الذي بعث في الأميين رسولا منهم يتلو عليهم آياته ويزكيهم ويعلمهم الكتاب والحكمة. He is the one, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So keep in mind, before our tradition, before our Sharia, scholars say there are different Sharia, some scholars say there are five different Sharias, and some say there are more, some say less. But before Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, before our Sharia, the Sharia that was implemented was Musa alayhi salam's. Because Isa alayhi salam did not have a new Sharia. He was, to the best of his ability and practice, he was a rabbi of that time. He fulfilled the Torah. And several passages in Torah say that I did not come with a new message. I came to fulfill the Torah, which means the book of Musa alayhi salam. And there are also several passages in the Bible, Old and New Testament, says that I did not come except the nation of Israelite and Bani Israel. So the Sharia for before us was Musa alayhi salam. Musa was messenger, he came with the book. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa messenger came with the book. And there are a lot of things that we have in common. Again, Quran is the last book, Muhammad is the last messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So therefore other books supplement and Quran comes as a final. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam can come as a final. So you have to keep in mind that Allah tells us about Musa alayhi salam and his people. Allah wants us to learn from those experiences. Allah wants us to reflect upon that. And one of the great scholars, Abu Dhar Kalam, he said, when you read Quran, So when you come across Ya Ayyuhallazina Amanu, Ya Ayyuhallazina Amanu, replace the Amanu in your head with your own name. Ya Ayyuhallazina Ejaz, Ya Ayyuhallazina Ali. Oh Ejaz, oh Ali, oh Fatima, why don't you do this? Why are you doing this? So Allah is talking to you. Ya ayyuhallazina amanu dukhulu fi silmi. Ya ayyuhallazina tubu ila Allahi tawbatan nasuh. Ya ayyuhallazina lima taquluna ma la. So think about Allah is talking to you directly. This is a conversation between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when you say amanu, O people of belief, yes, we are mu'min. We are the believer. So Allah is talking to me. What the ayah says, do something or don't do something. Same thing Allah tells over and over the history of Lut, Samud, Al, Nuh, Adam alayhi salam. But when it comes to Ya Bani Israel, it talks over and over and over and over and over. Ya Bani Israel, right before us. Faddalna. Allah has given them fazila. Allah has given high ranking. But what happened to them? Why? Because their love of their book. How did they understand the book? How did they implement? So Allah tells them, hey, there's one Sharia, one message came right before you. Watch what happened to them. Do not do what they did. And that's something that we have to pay close attention to it. So in this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, he is the one who has sent a messenger from you. Ummiyin, from you who is illiterate. This exact verbatim words are in the Bible, in Torah, and also New Bible. Jesus alayhi salam said, I have to go. So I have to leave so he can come. He is illiterate, he is from you, so he will teach you the glory of God. Same thing. That he is from you, he'll come from you, he's illiterate, he'll teach you. What? Think about it. So first of all, from this one, minhum has to be from you. So he is from you, you understand, you know him, he knows you very well. There's not something new that comes to you. So, oh, we didn't know that. Well, that, you know, for angels, you know, he's the only one unique. He came from, he doesn't understand. He doesn't have a wife. He doesn't have a husband. He doesn't have children. He doesn't have a job. He doesn't understand the culture. No, he's from you. So the lesson is that when you have a local leader, it has to be from you. One of us who understand the community, who can understand the culture, who can know what the community going through. If we have imported imam, imported khatib, imported somebody, they don't understand the culture and they're going to be rift in the community. So that's something that we need to establish. We need to have a local people, local leader, that we can understand each other, we can understand the culture, and we can keep the community together. It has to be from you, among you, who has a credibility. That's why Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam established his credibility. First thing he said, do you know who I am? When the revelation, the wahi come, do you know who I am? People got together. Do you know? Yes, we know. You sure? Yes, we know. Who are? As-sadiqul amin. And then he gives the example. Say, there is army coming, you'll follow. And then he say, okay, you understand. I am Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This credibility we need to establish. There is no credibility. There are two different lines. Ulama, khatib, shuyukh, they are just used as a need basis. Brother, lead the salah. Okay. Okay, we'll call you when nikah happens. Okay, when salat al-janazah, we'll text you. There is no leadership from the community. There is no connection. We use, abuse Imam Khatib, board of trustees separate, board of directors separate. There is no community essence. Look at the masajid and what's going on. There's always tug of war. Always tug of war. Because we don't have this minhum aspect from us, feeling of us, community networking, community together. No. And that's something that this ayah says is from you, he understands you, you understand him. What does he do? Yatlu alayhim ayatihim. First thing it does is what? Gives you signs. Why earth is here? Why sky is here? Why this ground is here? How about the camels? How about the star? Read the Quran. Full of it. Full of it. Talks about common sense, common logic. And then yatlu alayhim ayati. First he gives sign. Wayuzakkihim. Then he does tazkiyah. Do you understand this exists? Do you think I can do it? No. Do you think you can do it? No. Somebody, somewhere, right? What do you think? So feeling, understanding, the logic, then he does tazkiyah, purification of their heart. Yes, there is somebody, higher being. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Araf, I believe ayah number 171. Alastu bi rabbikum. Do you know who is the Lord, who is in charge, who is the sustainer? Qalu bala ya. Oh Allah, yes, we know you are. So this instinct is already in every single human being. There is Allah, there is a sustainer, it is there. But we just need to logically, you know,
tweak it logically, just tweak it logically, just move it little bit, little by little by little. That's what the Quran does. Daleel after daleel, slowly, slowly. Look at the Quran talks about camel. Quran talks about stars. Quran talks about earth. Quran talks about sand. Quran talks about the nabatat, you know, the trees. Why? Because these were the common aspects. Everybody can relate to it. And then Allah says, okay, do you think somebody created it? And then Muhammad SAW does tazkiyah, purification. Then he talks about yu'allimuhul kitab. So what we do, so brother, this is the Quran, we took shahada, okay, you need to memorize this, otherwise your salat is batal. Within a night, somebody takes shahada, we want that person to become Abu Bakr and Ali and Umar and Usman. And we yet stay Abu Jahl. It doesn't work. Quran has tadreej, everything slowly, slowly, slowly. You read about khamr, how it is forbidden, the liquor, the alcohol. Look at this interest, riba, sood, how is forbidden, slowly, gradually. Allah's sunnah is gradual, slow. We just want right away, within one night. Students, you know, my son should be half of the Quran. Muhaddas. Doesn't work. Human nature, slowly, slowly. So he does tazkiyah, then he teaches the kitab, wal hikmah. So okay, here's the law. First, does it make sense to you? Yeah. You do understand? Do you feel in your heart? Yeah. Okay, here's the law. Don't eat pig. Don't drink. Don't do fornication. How? Why? Here's hikmah. Here's the logic. Here's the reasoning. How can you run away from this? But we do reverse. Here's a kitab, here's a fatwa, here's a ayah, here's hadith. Yalla, that's it. And that whole thing is upside down. Children will pray when they see you. They will pray when you're around. They will not pray. And sometimes they'll pray because they're so scared. So okay, it's other time. Allahu Akbar. Okay, they'll come and pray without wudu. Because you scared them. And they're praying for you. They're not praying for God. And when you die, what will happen? And that's what exactly happened in 700 years in Spain. We had the best of best Muslim. Best. Ibn Hazm was there. Andalusia, you read history. What happened slowly, gradually, 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 it's gone. Today, you look at the cathedral, there's churches, ayat of Quran are still on the wall. Because we didn't logically approach. We didn't let the children ask questions. So don't ask questions. Astaghfirullah, it's haram. Brother, the hadith says that, and I believe in Muslim. Don't ask questions. No, really? Hadith is superior or Quran is superior? Quran, there's no question, right? Ala the sunnu, ala the shayya, doesn't matter who you are. Quran is superior. What does Quran tell us? Yas'alunaka lil khamr, yas'alunaka lil mayis, yas'alunaka lil ruh. They're asking about spirit, or they're asking about khamr, they're asking about this. They're asking, because they're asking, and Muhammad SAW answering, Allah is answering through Jibreel alayhi salam. Let children ask questions. That have this reasoning. The children spend 8 hours in a class. They have to raise their hand and they have to participate. They have to get grade. If they don't speak, they don't raise their hand, they're not going to get A. Doesn't matter how good they are. They come home, they're not allowed to ask questions. Astaghfirullah, don't. Why? Why? This is something that we need to understand. The tazkiyah, the building up. Then comes the law. First, the sign. Son, you want to talk about something? Okay, what do you want to talk about? Established fact? You want to talk about science? You think this is, you know, yeah, Dad, I can relate to science. I don't know about Quran. Okay, what do you want to talk about? You want to talk about fingerprinting? You want to talk about the two water splitting? Water can mix, right? But let me tell you, let's Google. There is a water that doesn't mix. We can see, right? Well, let's read Surah Ar-Rahman. It says water doesn't mix. Fingerprinting, let's read Surah An-Nisaa. Everything is created from cell. Okay, cell is what? 80% is water. Okay, let's read Surah Al-Anbiya. Everything is created from water. So you talk about established theory, son, we'll talk about Quran. They will love Quran. They will cite Quran. And that's why when the second time Muslim Ummah was at peak, second time, Bu Ali Sina, Jabir bin Ayan, all those scientists, some of them were half as a Quran. At that time, science was in the peak. Read the books of that time. Even Hindus, atheists, agnostic, they used to start the book, Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah, salatu salam ala Rasulullah. The influence of Muslim and scientists, the Quran was so much there that even you doing research, you don't believe in Quran, but you started this way. This thing, there is the book, there is the logic. This is something that we cannot negate. This is something that we need to pay attention, brother, sister. That's something lacking. He's from you, talks about science, he does purification of your heart, then he tells you this is the law, then he say, what's the logic behind the law? Once you approach this, it's deen al-fitra. Surah Rome, surah number 30, verse number 30. This deen is at the nature. It's fitra. So it will sink in very easily. Let me give you a couple more ayah. We don't have much time. Inshallah, we'll cover next time. Next ayah, مَسَلُ الَّذِينَ هُمَّلُوا التَّوْرَاةَ ثُمَّ لَمْ يَحْمِلُوا كَمَسَلِ الْحَمَارِ.
These are people like donkey holding books.
This is the Quran. مَسَلُ الَّذِينَ هُمَّلُوا التَّوْرَاةَ. The people those who had Tawrat, rabbis, they're like donkey. So donkey does not know he has a Quran on his back and he has just fiction on his back. He's just loaded, but he has a books on his back. So these are the people loaded with books like a donkey. Don't understand what's in the book. And they ask question over and question over. The question that are useless. Question that has some meaning is encouraging in Quran. Question that are useless, completely discouraging Quran. Read Surah Baqarah, first 70 ayah about the cow. What kind of cow? Simple, one cow, the slaughter, done. Oh, what color? What shape? Where should be? How should be? Allah kept on making higher and higher and higher and higher. Today we do exact same thing, brother and sister. Oh, Khizr al-Islam was Sufi? Was it Wali? Was it Nabi? Did he have Sharia? Did he exist? Allahu Akbar! Surah Kaf, how many people were there? Five? Six was dark? Seven? Eight was dark? Nine? Eight. Wait a second! Don't you get the message that an ordinary person, the telling, one who is Kalimullah, who talked directly to Allah, an ordinary person telling him, you don't know. Nobody knows, only Allah knows, brother. That's the message. But instead of Khizr al-Islam, where was he? Was he Wali? Was he Sufi? Wait a second. What are we doing? What kind of cow should be? What color should be? Irrelevant, brother and sister. The relevant is message. And that's what we're doing. That's what Muhammad SAW said. That's where you look at this. That's what we do. We'll have, inshallah, you know, Allah bless all scholars. I have no beef with any scholars. No beef with any Muslim. Because my deen tells me you love Allah. You love Allah's creation. Quran says Allah hasn't created anything without purpose. So everything is purposeful for us. I love everything. We all love as a Muslim Allah and Allah's creation. Therefore, no question. But we will have Salatul Taraweeh here, starting from May 17, depending on moon sign. The Qari will stand here and start from Alif Lam Mim to An-Nas. 6,634 verses. We will stand hours and hours behind. Ask what happened. Oh, brother, I don't know. I'm just office. Did you understand? Well, I don't know. Why can't we pay attention and ask the same Qari, brother, what are you going to recite tomorrow? They have a syllabus. They have a structure. That they're going to do 40 ayah of Surah Baqarah today. Next 40 to 80, 80 to 120. Ask the brother what you're going to recite tomorrow night and put the CD in your car when you're driving. Listen the translation. Listen the ayah. Listen the tafsir. And when you come and stand behind, you will never get bored. You will enjoy it and you will be crying. Oh my God, this is the incident of Musa al-Islam. Oh my God, this is Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Oh my God, this is Qawm al-Lut. You will enjoy it and you will cry. You will cry because you'll understand. But we don't. مَسَلُ الَّذِينَ هُمِّلُوا التَّوْرَاةِ ثُمَّ لَمْ يَحْمِلُوا كَمَسَلِ الْحَمَارِ. This is like donkey loaded with book. Brother, please don't park here. Why? Because we have inspector watching. Come on, man. I'm Hafiz Quran. I've been parking here for 30 years. Where's ayah in Quran? تَعَوَنْ عَلَى الْبِرِ. This brother is a volunteer sitting in the snow telling you, please don't park here. Just helping the masjid, the community. You have a Hafiz Quran. So I'm going to do whatever I want to. But your Quran tells you, help in a good deed. He's doing good deed. Quran tells you, Ayyul Lazina Amanu, Atiullah, Atiur Rasul, Awlil Amri Minkum. Obey Allah, Allah's Rasul, those who are in charge. He is in charge in traffic right now. No, brother. Masalul Lazina Hummilat Tawrah. This is what we have right now, brother and sister. We can load, we can come and give you speech. Where is the Quran? It's not in the heart. This is the same Quran ayah that he changes people's heart. Umar ibn Khattab has a sword in his hand. He will say, I want to go kill Muhammad. He comes back as one of the greatest Khalifa. Because Quran ayah, Surah Taha. Not from a Qari, a Hafiz, a Muballigh, his sister reciting, hiding. But one ayah, listen, wait a second, can you do it more? Because we need to have understanding. Let me give you a last ayah, inshallah. We don't have time, we'll talk next time. This ayah ends with, Qazzabu bi ayatina. These are those who have declined, denied, and done takzeeba for ayat. Find me a single rabbi in history, even today, who says Torah is wrong. Nobody does. Not a single rabbi will do that. So how does Allah say these are the people who deny Torah? How? Because the Torah tells them to do something, they're completely doing opposite. Torah tells them to do this, they're completely doing opposite. Today, Quran tells us, be honest, open your heart, open your chest, love everybody is Allah's creation. Doesn't matter which Muslim, which Maslak, which culture, which language. No, brother, no, you know, he doesn't have a longer beard. But doesn't have a baya. But doesn't have a good makhraj. Or he's not graduated from the madrasa. Well, he graduated from this madrasa, but not the one I believe in. Or he graduated from this country, but not... Allahu Akbar! What are we doing? What are we doing? Brother, I don't believe him. I believe my sheikh. The question in Qabr is Man Rabbuka, not Rabbukuma, Rabbukum, Rabbuhum. Who is your Rabb? Ma Dinuka, what's your Deen? Ma Takulu fi Haqq al Hazar Rajul, what you say about this person? It's you, not your Shaykh. So brother and sister, worry about yourself. We have done PhD in the subject that people can't even think about. Physics, music. But when it comes to Quran, we don't have understanding. Basic book. What we did, we put in a book in subcontinent, we put the Quran in the Khalaf, in the covering, on top of somewhere. We take the Quran out when we have fight. Brother, I put my hand on the Quran. Wallah billah, you owe me $10,000. Oh brother, you know my daughter gonna get married. Can you hold the Quran on her head? Allahu Akbar. That was the book was to cover. Afala yatadabbaruna al-Quran. When are you going to ponder about this book? So let me give you a last example. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, what did he say? Think about Muhammad. La tatabi'unna sunana kana man qablukum. You will follow the people. Those who speak Arabic, there's emphasis in word. Arabic is a rich language. La tatabi'unna. For sure and sure and sure and sure. You can't even translate this. You will follow man kana man qablukum, those who were before. Shibran, 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 zara'in bi zara'in. Shibr is this. In Arabic, in Urdu, it's in balisht. Like this. Shibran, shibran, that close, that close. Bi zara'in, zara'in, like this close, this close. You would follow. So close. Walau dahalo, even if they enter, hujran dabbin, in the lizard hole, tobe tobohum, you will follow them. Qalu ya Rasulullah, al Yahud al Nasara. You mean Christian Jews? Kala Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, for man. Who else do you think I mean? Today, exactly what we're doing. You go into a synagogue. There is a book, Torah, it's decorated, sits there. There's a stick right next to it, it's called Yada. Only rabbi can read Torah with that stick. It shouldn't touch the book. It's not for general public. Brother, don't read Quran yourself, you'll get confused. Brother, don't understand, you know, because you might not understand, and that can be a problem for you. Only rabbi can read it, not general public. Today, if you need to ask this guy because he speaks better than me. He knows Arabic. In Qabr, the guy won't be there. Allah knows where he will be. So, brother and sister, we need to love this Quran. We need to come back. This surah has so many lessons, so many lessons. I didn't even get a chance to go through. But the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam giving khutbah and sahaba walked away. So think about that. How did that happen? Yes, sahaba were a human being. And Allah wanted to put that incident to relate to us. That do not run away. But Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam giving khutbah. But there is a risk from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wallahu khair raziqeen. That's how it ends. Allah give risk. Those who have children 2 years, 3 years old. Oh brother, my daughter or my son is 2 years old. No. MashaAllah, he's eating banana. No. He's eating cereal. No. He's growing up. Really? Same banana, same cereal. The child is 20 years old, 30 years old. Feed him. 10 pounds. It doesn't grow. How? Allah is the one who is making him or her grow. Allah is the one who is giving the risk and sustaining. The banana and this thing does not make it grow. No, my child is growing now. No, Allah makes it go. So this ayah ends with Wallahu khairul raziqeen. Allah is the one who gives the best risk. There are a lot of ayahs I missed. So inshallah, go home and read the tafsir. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us wisdom, vision, and strength that we can understand the Quran, we can love the Quran, implement upon our life, and then convey to others with hikmah, open our heart, chest, and love everybody, love Allah's creation. You do not know today's worst enemy can be tomorrow's best khalifa of this nation for Muslim Ummah. That is a sunnah of Sahaba, that is sunnah of Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Go back to our rich tradition, pristine tradition, and love everybody. You don't know who's going to turn and where and when. May Allah give us wisdom and strength. Inna Allah malakata yusalluna النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين خاتم النبيين ورحمة العالمين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. اللهم إني نسألك من الخير كله ونعوذ بك من شر كله. آمين ثم آمين يا رب العالمين. أقيم الصلاة.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. I have a few announcements, very important, brother. First of all, Sheikh Sabir giving us like example of those people who have books like a donkey on. He have a books on his back. We are going to start, inshallah, revising Quran Halaqa. we want to see how many people are interested. Understanding the Quran is very important for all of us. We have to go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Quran is a full life guidance for those who understand. So please come to me, see Brother Hussein. We want to make a registration, then we will decide. It should be on maybe not this week, maybe next Saturday, between Asr and Maghrib or Maghrib and Isha. We will see how many people. Secondly, very important, Ikna convention is going on following Saturday, not this tomorrow, but next Saturday. If you registered yourself, want to go attend over there, this is very important events. Very important, you go with the family and you will be having a chance to hear from scholars from the different countries and from local, and you will meet with other communities, other Muslim community from all over the countries. If you go by yourself, it will be $150, but Masjid Ibrahim have arranged, the bus will go from here 8:30, they will charge only $25 return trip. They will come back same night, same day. You spend whole day and you just pay 25, including the trip and the registration. And the third thing is that, this is a request, tomorrow Saturday, we will have a dua for my father and all those of your relatives, including whole Ummah Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, between Asr and Maghrib. Please join us. This is open invitation for everyone. And secondly, who was not here last Friday, starting today, 2:10, we will have a second Jummah to accommodate those people who have difficulties to come to join on the first Jummah. So please come. Assalamu alaikum. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله هيا الصلاة هيا الصلاة هيا الفلاح هيا الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله.
Allahu Akbar. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. Maliki Yawm al-Din. Iyaka na'bud wa Iyaka nasta'in. اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواسوا بالحق وتواسوا بالصبر. الله أكبر.
الله.
سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
الله
أكبر.
الله
أكبر. الله أكبر.
الله
الحمد لله رب العالمين.
الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
I'm going to go to the hospital. I'm going to go to the hospital. I'm going to go to the hospital.